HTMX. It takes your boring HTML and makes it a little naughty. How so? Well, traditionally, developers have had two choices when creating interactive web experiences. Multi-page applications, which refresh the entire page every time a user interacts with it, and single-page applications, which rely on JavaScript running in the browser to manage the application's state. To avoid the clunkiness of multi-page applications, many developers in the past decade have relied on front-end frameworks and libraries to deliver more fluid user experiences. However, single-page applications have disadvantages, like shipping a lot of JavaScript to the client, learning a complex ecosystem, and arguing with other developers why your framework of choice is far superior. HTMX takes an approach somewhere in the middle by offering the interactivity of single-page applications while maintaining the server-side simplicity of multi-page applications, and does all of this directly from HTML elements.
Baby, I like your drool.
It achieves this by using distinct HTML attributes like AJAX attributes for handling requests. There are also trigger attributes for handling which event will cause the request, target attributes for handling what elements should load the response, and swap attributes for handling how the HTML is swapped in the target element. Let's get HTMX installed and look at some examples. You can install HTMX via a CDN, import it locally, or use a package manager like NPM. This means it can be plugged into whatever tech stack you already use. Once you have that installed, let's look at an app built with HTMX that tracks our favorite movies. First, we need to load our movies, which are being placed inside the main element. This element calls a GET request to our movies endpoint, fires the request when the element loads in the DOM, and places all the HTML coming back from the server inside the element. Each element has a button that can be used to remove the movie from the database. You can see that this button calls a delete request. The outer HTML value means that this entire list element will be replaced with what's returned from the server, which is nothing, making the element disappear from the DOM. Last, we have a form for adding new movies. The form makes a post request to our movies endpoint and targets the list of movies by its class. The server will return the new movie that's added, which will add to the end of the list by using the before end swap value. Watch this video for a speedrun of Alicia.js, which is the bun framework I use for this project's server, and be sure to check out the complete code example in the description below. That's it for HTMX. Let me know in the comments what speedrun you want to see next.